If TG Mythic Hunter is in the house, then I have a sheer random collection of packs to break open. Skadoosh. I found, or these packs came to me from Whatnot, Rabbit Hole. I should really stop buying randomness, but it is pretty fun. The first pack that I'm going to crack is the Hunger Games. It has six packs in here. I'm willing to bet that it's all about the movie. Let's see if this is a cool product or not. Pack up first. High gloss finish to these cards. It's a pretty thick cardstock. Card quality is pretty nice for what the product is. Just simple pictures from the games. Here's what one of the backs look like. Nothing special. I really do not like square corner cards though. So, up next we have a Jim Lee's Wildcats 8 Deluxe Trading Cards produced by Topps. Two prism cards randomly inserted every 36 packs. Looks like it was printed, manufactured, possibly in 93. Let's see how this pack opens up. Again, another square corner product. That's okay. Got a cool hologram emblem on top. There. Again, Stan Lee Comics, right? No, Jim Lee Comics, Wildcats. Wildcats. Ugly. Sister Zealot's Help. Grifter, Voodoo, and Marvel are safe. Or are they? The Coda Assassin, still not dead, has one last trick up her sleeve. She has no sleeve. Detonates a massive explosion, leveling the club and everyone in it, including the Wildcats. Dun 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 dun! Stay tuned for next episode. I'm gonna open up some Anastasia. There's five trading cards produced by Upper Deck. Asia, 1998, 20th Century Fox Films Corporation, Upper Deck, all rights reserved. Okay. Yeah. fun the first time, let's do it again. So there's a collector number down here in the bottom. Not really sure how many cards there would be in the set. Kind of sticky. I think that's just a gloss finish. There's some Anastasia cards. Cool. Scenes from the cartoon movie. That's what all of this little collection is about. Again, sheer randomness purchased one night on Whatnot. Thin cards, so I do have a bunch of art cards that are like this. I've got a couple complete sets from some other artists. I've yet to showcase those. Oh, this is a sticker or some type of stand-up punch-out. What is it? Instructions. Punch-out figure, bleeding figure, attach at A, flip card B, blah, 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 blah. And I got a stand-up cut-out sticker. Character dude. That's kind of cool. Art is kind of really cool for these cards. The dog. I got a raccoon cut out. Cool. Your collection of Pocahontas cards. Up next, I have three packs of The Hunchback of Notre Dame. 11 cards per pack, including a finger puppet, builder collar puppet. That's kind of cool. Bunch of stuff in these. Welcome to the world of card collecting. Cards are produced by Skybox. Never heard of it. Of course, I've never really heard of half of these cards that I just cracked open for you guys. But I'm sure everybody's trying to make a buck these days. Everybody's going to try to make a card product, because card products are collectible, they're investable, they're tradable, playable, and look at me, I'm making content with it. Let's see here, so we have a little intro book to the world of card collecting. CCGs, TCGs, yeah, okay, so exclusive limited edition 3D motion card. Build a tower card, puzzle cards, some iron on. That's kind of cool. This might be a cool little thing to. Thank you. Jester's Challenge activity. Without touching it, guess how many cards are in a discard pile within 3. Game effect. Okay. Oops. Punch the puzzle. Didn't want to punch the puzzle yet.
It's a puzzle.
Okay. Some coin cards. Okay. I'll find the heart cards, huh? Lord. Determination and encourage Quasimodo, rescues his friends and Esmeralda. And we're gonna go. Finished. Did I do that right? I think I did. Another puzzle card. And it looks like to be one of those punch cards and a finger puppet card. Okay, back to art. Here's a coin card. And another puzzle card. And a challenge card. Rules. Holographic moving cards. Oh, yeah. That is cool. Wing it. Looks like getting slapped. Ooh, that's a big, thick boy there. All of those things aside, that's one of those puzzle punch card things. That's another one. That's another one. Wow, there's so much random insert stuff. We got another puzzle. Quasimodo and the gargoyles use all their strength to hurl giant wooden logs over the cathedral ledge to drive Frollo's soldiers away. So, we start in here, we go on this way, we go this way. Finished. This thing out of. Saw a couple of puzzles. Wow. Those 3 packs. And this is all that there was for art cards. Everything else is a random insert game, puzzle, piece, game token. I missed something there. That was just sheer weirdness. That's all right. I didn't know what to expect, really. And like I said, I do like the art cards. I'm just not a big fan of square corner cards. They're really hard to keep in a really good, pristine condition if you want to try and keep it in a pristine condition. Go ahead and check out those links down in the description. MTG Mythic Hunter, and you just watched Investable Collectibles crack some random packs of who knows if you want to call it goodness. I like to call it art. Thanks for watching.